Hello students, today we are going to discuss the topics Human Genome Project and DNA fingerprinting. Earlier you have studied about that how DNA forms RNA and RNA forms protein. So till now you have the concept that the genetic constitution of an organism, it lies in the DNA of the organism. So therefore this important project which is called Human Genome Project is so important. Now let us study about details of Human Genome Project. Under Human Genome Project, we are going to study about the goals of HGP, the methodologies adopted to study HGP, and the salient features of HGP, and what are the applications of Human Genome Project. The first very important question that strikes our mind is, what is a genome? A genome is all the DNA that is present in an organism. If you look into the picture, the very small nucleus that contain the whole DNA of the organisms, and how the DNA that forms a protein, and the protein affects the phenotype of an organism. Now, what is the use of studying HGP? So, what we know till now, the DNA has all the information about an organism. And two individuals vary due to differences in DNA sequences. So there is a need to find out the complete DNA sequence in the human. That why there is a biodiversity, why two individuals don't look the same. So the Human Genome Project is a big project. It is also called the mega project. The human genome, as it is known, it contains 3×10⁻⁶ base pairs. And this project was launched in 1990. Now let's understand some of the important goals of HGP. It is basically to identify 20,000 to 25,000 genes in man. Second, to determine 3 billion chemical base pairs. Number third, to store information in databases. And fourth very important goal is to improve tools for data analysis. All these goals have led to a new branch of biology, what we now today known as bioinformatics. Now let us see the methodologies to study HGP. The first important methodology is express sequence text, that is to identify genes that expresses RNA. Here we identify only the genes that is expressed. And the second important methodology is sequenced annotation. So that is a blind approach where the genes are sequenced whether they are coding or non-coding. That it contains both the introns and the exons. And later on the functions are assigned to them. Now what are the steps of DNA sequence? Let us study the steps of the DNA sequence. The first is the DNA is isolated from cell. As you can see in the picture, the cell is homogenized and the DNA is extracted chemically. Then the DNA extracted, it is converted into random small fragments with the help of molecular scissors called restriction antinucleases. The fragmented DNA is then cloned into suitable host using vectors. The host which are generally used is a bacteria or yeast, and the vectors which are used to carry the genome is BAC, that is bacterial artificial chromosome, or YAC, yeast artificial chromosome. If you look into the picture, that shows the picture of E. coli and the yeast and BAC and the YAC vectors. The next diagram clearly indicates that how the DNA is cloned. Now here is the donor DNA. The donor DNA is split into the fragments of DNA. It is attached to the vector by the enzyme DNA ligase, and then it was introduced into a host cell, especially the bacterial cells, and when the bacteria replicates along with that, the recombinant DNA molecules also replicate. And in this way, you have a clone of DNA molecules. So the next picture shows that from a small portion of the DNA, so many different copies of the same DNA can be produced, which we call clone. And after that, the DNA is put into the DNA sequencer. as you can see in the picture, that the sample buffer that contains the DNA fragments is passed through a laser. And with the help of fluorescence detector, you can see the different graphs, different colors for the different bases. A red color for the T, a green color, the yellow color for the G, green color for the A. In this way, you have a different color for the different bases and different peaks. So when the DNA fragments are put into the DNA sequencer, you get the base pairs. Now let us see what are the applications of this to understanding the biological system, and second, how genes work together. As you can see in the picture, that there's a human diversity project. We all are different, we all are unique. No two individuals are unique. So with the help of Human Genome Project, it is to be understood that what is the basis for the different biological system operating in the nature. Now the next important topic that we are going to deal with is the DNA fingerprinting. You must have heard about this particular technique which has been used in the criminal offense. So now let us study in detail about the different process of DNA fingerprinting. So we are going to study the meaning of the fingerprinting, the principle behind the technique, and the various process. So what is the meaning of DNA fingerprinting? Basically, DNA fingerprinting is the DNA profile of an individual. It is based on the principle that the DNA has 3×10^6 base pairs which are arranged in a definite sequence. Certain regions are repeated, which are called repetitive DNA. These regions are G2C or A2T rich. These regions show polymorphism, that they do not code for any proteins. These polymorphisms are inheritable from parent to children, and these occur due to mutations. So the variation is at the genetic level. Now, what do you mean by polymorphism? Polymorphism means at this particular point, which we call repetitive DNA, they show variations in the base pairs. And these base pairs remain constant from parent to offspring. This repetitive DNA is also called satellite DNA. They have VNTRs, that is, variable number of tandem repeats. These are specific and these are inheritable. So as the picture shows, that you can see the sequence, how the satellite DNA sequence and how much they are coiled in the DNA. Now during the process of DNA fingerprinting, let us see that which are the sources from where the DNA fingerprinting is done. The sources are the blood, semen, hair, saliva or tissue bits. Now let us see what are the steps of the DNA fingerprinting. The first step is the sample collection, that is from the site. The second is the isolation of DNA that we have already studied. Then digestion of DNA, that is by molecular restriction enzymes. Then splitting into single strand DNA. Then the transfer of DNA fragment to nylon sheath. Hybridization with label VNTR probe. And the autoradiography to detect hybridized DNA. So now let us summarize the various steps of the DNA fingerprinting with the help of the following diagram. This particular technique uses Southern blotting. Now let us see how the blotting takes place with the help of the following diagram. The DNA is extracted. It is a restriction enzyme that produces the fragment. Then double-stranded fragment separated by electrophoresis. The denatured to single-stranded fragment, transferred to gel to the membrane, and radioactive label probe in a single strand. They cover the membrane with probe and then incubate. Then the excess probe is washed and then it is visualized by exposure to X-ray film, and the film is developed. The DNA typing pattern appears. At the end of the process, you can find the DNA patterns in the form of bands. So after understanding the technique of DNA fingerprinting, let's try this and tell whether you can find out the biological son and daughter. Now you have the DNA pattern for the mom and the dad, and there are two daughters D1, D2 and two sons S1 and S2. By looking into the DNA pattern of the mom and dad, try to find out which one is the true daughter and which one is a true son. Now you can see here the DNA pattern of D1, it matches with the mom and dad. So that is the D1 is the true daughter. On the other hand, if you see for the son, the S1, the DNA pattern is similar to mom and the dad. So S1 is the true son. So let us summarize the topic that we have studied just now. Genome is the total DNA present in an organism. Two individuals are not same due to differences in DNA sequences. Human body has 3 billion base pairs. HGP is a mega project. DNA fingerprinting is DNA profile of an individual. The technique is based on the presence of VNTRs, which are inheritable. Wide application in forensic department. Now check your understanding. Human body has chemical base pairs. What are the two methodologies to study HGP? Polymorphisms are, two options are there, inheritable, not heritable. Polymorphism occur due to repetitive DNA is also called DNA. Digestion of DNA is done by expand VNTRs. So students, we have finished with the molecular basis of inheritance. In the next discussion, we are going to discuss the chapter evolution. Thank you.